Today we are going to start with tetracyclines. So tetracyclines are the non-beta-lactam antibiotics. They do not contain beta-lactam ring. Okay? They are obtained from fermentation procedures or from Streptomyces species. Chemical transformation of natural. You try to chemically modify some of the natural products to get your tetracycline. You do the modification in the structures to get semi-synthetic tetracycline. So what is this tetracycline mean? Basically chemically made. It contains an octahydronaphthalene ring. If you can see, there are four rings A, B, C, D, and they are octahydro, means there are eight hydrogens which are extra in your naphtha, saturated, unsaturated. Okay. There are five double bonds. If you can see in the ring D, there are three in ring B, one, and ring A, one. So there are total five double bonds. And this is the structure of your natural penicillin, your natural tetracycline. So it contains an amide bond at the second position, an enol bond at the second and third carbon, and dimethyl amino group at the fourth. It has got a methyl and a hydroxy group at the sixth position, and it has got an OH and a carbonyl. OH at the 10th, carbonyl at the 11th. There is a double bond between 11A and 12. There is an hydroxyl group at 12 and 12A. And at the first position, it contains a carbonyl group. This is the structure of a natural penicillin, which contains hydroxyl group at and methyl group at the 6th position. If you see, there is a conjugated bond. Your double bond is conjugated with your carbonyl group. It's a conjugated double bond. Okay, the double bonds are conjugated with your carbonyl. This is very much important. This is very much important for the structure of your tetracycline. So basically, it contains four fused rings with five double bonds, and it has got seven hydrogens, and it is called naphthacin. Okay, octahydro naphthacin moiety. So tetracycline possesses wide spectrum of activity. It's a broad spectrum activity against both gram negative and gram positive bacteria. So it's got a broad spectrum. It's an example of broad spectrum activity. They are mainly designed for oral route, but parenteral and topical routes are also basically for oral route. At present, many cases such as toxic drug resistant development of more effective and the uses of this thing because of the resistance and toxicity. So their use has been decreased. Okay, because of the toxicity and other reasons, the use of tetracycline has been limited nowadays. So now let's go for the classification of tetracycline. Now, according to the duration of action. So according to the duration of action, they can be classified as short acting, that is half-life less than 6 to 8 hours, tetracycline and oxytetracycline. Intermediate half-life around 12 hours. Dimethylcycline and methacycline. See the examples. We will be explaining why later when we will be going to the structures. And long acting means it has got a long half-life. That is doxycycline and minocycline. Okay, doxycycline and minocycline. So this is the classification of tetracycline according to the duration of action. So now let's go for the mechanism. These tetracyclines are specific inhibitor of bacterial protein synthesis. So they inhibit the protein synthesis. How does they do it? They bind with the 30S ribosomal subunit and thereby prevent the binding of aminoacyl tRNA to an mRNA, that is ribosomal complex. So your tRNA and so that messenger RNA does not transfer its protein sequence to your tRNA for your further development of your proteins. So this is blocked because they inhibit by the bonding between the two by binding at the 30S subunit, okay, of 30S ribosomal subunit. Triclosan also inhibit your proteins in the host, but it is likely to reach the concentration required because eukaryotic cells do not have a tetracycline uptake mechanism. So we don't have that tetracycline uptake mechanism, only the bacterials have. So thus, it is not that effective in case of, it does not affect your eukaryote. So this is the
mechanism of action.
Now let's go for the chemistry. As I said, it consists of four benzene rings with various constituents on the rings. You can see there was four benzene rings with partial unsaturation. Okay, with partial unsaturation. Their crystalline bases are faintly yellow, odorless, slightly bitter compound. They are slightly soluble in water at pH of 7, but they form a soluble
sodium
and hydrochloride. So they form both sodium and your hydrochloride. Now let's see the detail the chemical structure. So what it is, it's an, these are derivatives of octahydronaphthalene, which comprise of four fused six membered ring. As you can see, there are four six membered ring which are fused together. They have around 5 to 6 chiral centers. If you see the chiral center at the 6th carbon, 4th carbon, and you can see it at the 4A, 12A. So these are all the chiral centers. Why? Because there are four different groups attached to that particular carbon atom. Okay, 6, 5A, 4A, 4, and 12A. So these are all the chiral centers. And they are amphoteric in nature. Why it is called that they are amphoteric in nature? If you see the pK, because of the presence of your amino group, it is basic in nature, and the amide in all. So it is, and moreover, because of the presence of conjugated carbonyl group and OH. As I said, there are conjugation. If you see between 10 and 11 and 12, there is a conjugated carbonyl and OH. So there is a resonance difference. So this makes the portion acidic. So they have got both acidic as well as basic group present in this. So they are amphoteric in nature. They can act as an acid as well as an basic. So they have got both the criteria. They have got acidic as well as basic. Okay. Now let's go further. So this is the overall structure of your tetracycline, which are very important for your tetracyclines. So let's go one by one. So there is A, B, C, D. A1, which is on the right hand side. A ring is at the right hand side. Let us go one by one. What is present in the A ring? Presence of enolized tricarbonyl methyl system. If you see C1 and C3, there is a carbonyl group and there is an enol group. There is a carbonyl at the first position. There is an enol that is called carbonylized methylated. So there is a carbonyl at the first position. There is double bond between 2 and 3 and there is an OH group. So this is called as a tricarbamyl methyl system because there it contains an enol that is double bond and OH and then carboxylic. Moreover, at the second position, it has got an amide, which is essential for your activity. And one of the hydrogens may be, in case of amides, one of the hydrogen can be replaced, but not both. So your one of the hydrogen in your amide can be replaced, but not the both. Now let's go for the next. So this was 1, 2, 3 position. Now let's go for the fourth position. Your protonated dimethyl. So if you got an dimethyl substitution at the fourth position, it has got the most potent compound. Okay, and the most important thing that it should have an alpha configuration. Remember, it should have an alpha configuration. Okay, the amino group the dimethyl amino group which is essential should be of alpha configuration for the activity. They form zitterion, which is for your optimal distribution. They play a very important role in the PK of the, in the DMPK properties of the drug. Okay. Now, at the fifth position, it might contain removal of OH. Deoxy compounds have no effect. Presence of OH at the fifth, if you can see the structure, fifth position, there is no OH. So, dimethoxy compound does not, if you, presence of your OH at the fifth position or without, has no effect on the activity.
Okay.
The linear ring are essential. Okay. The ring should be linear. Derivatives with more than four rings are inactive and less than four rings are inactive. Opening of the rings or aromatization of an additional ring makes it. So if you try to have an additional aromatic ring, like on the three double bonds in other than D, if there is three double bond across the system, the compound becomes inactive. And the region 5, carbon 5 to carbon 9 has said to be hydrophobic region. Means that gives your lipophilicity to the drug for your penetration. So the carbon 5 to 9 are important for giving hydrophobic region. So increase the lipophilicity of the drug. If you see at the 6th carbon, alpha methyl and beta hydroxy may not be essential for your activity. Because methyl and OH at the 6th position might not be necessary for the activity. Next is the presence of an electron withdrawing ring at the 7th position, like chloro, nitro, with a strong electron, or a strong electron donating group as the NN dimethyl increase the activity. So presence of an electron donate withdrawing group like chlorine nitro, as well as presence of an electron donating group that is NN dimethyl amine at the 7th position, see at the 7th on the top, will increase the activity. So both electron donating and electron withdrawing group increase the activity at the 7th position. Okay, the OH at the 10th, the carbonyl at the 11th, and the OH at the 12th. These groups are very much important for your active. The phenol ketone moiety. Phenol ketone, why? Because there is a phenol, that is your aromatic ring attached to your OH. And a carbonyl group at the 11th is important for your activity. So if that ring carbonyl group is broken, or the ring is broken, then the activity is lost. Conjugation between 10 to 12. What did I say? Conjugation, double bond in conjugation with your carbonyl group. If you see 10, 11, 12. So there is a double bond followed by a carbonyl group and followed by a double bond. So this is known as conjugation. The conjugation between 10 to 12 is necessary. If this conjugation is not there, then the compound is said to be inactive. So this is an overall picture. By looking at the diagram, by the structure, we can say which all groups are necessary for your activity. Which all groups are necessary for your activity. Now let's go in deep the SAR of tetracycline. That was the preview. Let's go one by one according to the ring. Derivatives with less than four fused rings are said to be inactive. As I mentioned, there should be minimum four rings. Okay, less than four or more than four makes the compound inactive. Simplest structures with retained activities was 6-dimethyl, 6-deoxytetra. So if you remove OH and methyl at the sixth position, as you have seen earlier, you get the your activity is retained without methoxy. Methyl and OH at the sixth position, that is R2 and R3, your activity was retained. There was no need. Now, the next thing, it was the first criteria. Now, let's go for the second. substitution at 1, 2, 3, 4. If you see, 1 is carbonyl, 2 is amide, 3 between 2 and 3 double bond and OH, 4th enantiomethyl amide, 10th that is your OH, 11th that is your double carbonyl, 11A and 12 between 11A that is double bond OH at the 12th position cannot be modified. If you try to modify this all substitution between 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 11A and 12, if any modification is there, this will lead to the loss of activity. There will be no better compound activity. So this positions has not to be changed. This positions should not be changed. If you can see, C1, carbonyl, second, amide, double bond between 2 and 3, necessary for your activity. OH at the third position, enantiomethyl amide with an alpha configuration, necessary for your activity. Then carbonyl, OH at the 10th in the aromatic phenolic OH, carbonyl at the 11th and the double bond OH between the 12 and 11. These are necessary for your activity. These are necessary for your activity. Slight modification in A ring is tolerable without dramatic. So you can just make some modification in A ring. As I said, you can have a monomethylated amide and you can have demethylated amino. Okay, that is tolerated. That is tolerated. Now, regarding A ring, as I said, it is an enolized carbonyl system. If you can see, carbonyl at the 1 with an enol between 2 and 3. It is necessary. Okay. This cannot be modified. Replacement of amide. If you remove the amide group by a nitro or an aldehyde, the activity is completely lost. Monoalkylation reduces the activity, but activity will be there, but it will be lesser. So mono substitution of amide is possible, but your activity will be reduced. Dimethyl amino group at the C4. Look at it. A dimethyl substitution at C4, okay, can be a free amide or a monomethyl amide and methyl amide, but cannot be longer than your methyl, cannot be any larger alkyl. You cannot substitute with an ethyl, propyl, isopropyl, nothing. Only methyl group, alkyl group is permissible. Any other substitution, greater alkyl group, it is not tolerated. Demethylated activity is retained. So this is the, moreover, the alpha orientation is very important. If you convert it into a beta isomer orientation, the activity is lost. Okay, the activity is lost. So remember this thing, very much important, your alpha configuration. Now between A and B, so what is the cis configuration? That means your, in case of your OH, the high priority groups between the A and B ring should be at the same plane and the low priority group should be in the opposite plane. Okay, so this is very much important. The cis configuration between A ring and B ring is very much important. That is OH and at the your 4A and your OH at the 12A is necessary, should be of the cis configuration. Now OH group at 12A, if you see OH group at 12A, it should be free. If you try to convert it into an ester or any other group, the activity is abolished. So your OH at the 12th A position is very much essential for your activity. Hydrophobic substitution. Okay, hydrophobic substitution at 5 and 5A, 6, 7, 8, 9 results in retention of your activity and somewhat improvement. So you can have an hydrophobic substitute like methyl and all at the 5th position. 5A, 5A, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you, at this position, you can have an hydrophobic substitution. This will improve the activity. Presence of OH at does not have presence of OH at the fifth position does not have any important role in active. This was seen in dimethylcycline and deoxytetracycline compared to minoxicillin and doxycycline. So if you remove your OH group from the fifth position, it did not have much effect on the activity.
Okay.
So it was not important. Example, minocycline and doxycycline in comparison with oxytetracycline and dimethylcycline. These compounds were said to be better and long duration of action. Now, 6, neither 6 alpha nor 6 beta, okay, is essential. If you remove OH at the and the methyl at the 6th position, that is example doxycycline and methacycline, are more active than your oxytetracycline. So if without your OH at the 6th and methyl, the activity was retained. Okay, example doxycycline and methacycline are more active than oxytetracycline. These derivatives are also more stable. So if you remove OH and methyl and replace it with some other group, these compounds were said to be more stable and acid resistance and base inactivation. So if you remove methyl and OH from the 6th position and replace it with some other groups like methylene group, okay, they have got better activity. As you say in methacycline your OH and methyl at the 6th position is replaced by a CH double bond CH2. Okay, it is replaced by a double bond. They are more lipophilic and better absorbed orally and high protein. Because of this, they have got better lipophilicity as well as they have got high protein and have long duration of action. So if you see the example, methacycline is a long acting tetracycline because of this reason. Because of the presence of double bond, it is more stable. It is not affected by your acid as well as base inactivation. It has got more lipophilic characters and more protein bonding. That's why it increases the duration of action. So let's go for now structures. The first structure is your tetracycline. If you see the structure of tetracycline, one by one, carbonyl group at the first, amide at the second, double bond between 2 and 3, OH at the third, NN dimethyl amine at the fourth, which is of alpha configuration. There is no OH group at the fifth position. Remember, in case of tetracycline, there is no OH or any substitution at the fifth position. At the sixth position, it contains your OH and methyl. Your OH is of beta configuration and your methyl is of alpha configuration. At the 10th position, there is an OH. At the 11th position, there is a double bond carbonyl group. There is a double bond between 11 and 12 and OH. And at the 12A position, there is an OH. Okay, so this is the structure of tetracycline. Keep it as a standard. Now let's see, this was naturally off. Now let's see, how did they synthetically modify this tetracycline? First thing they did is chlor tetracycline. Rest all structure is same. Look at it carefully. Only thing is that they have introduced an chloro at the 7th position. That's the only difference between your tetracycline and chlorotetracycline. At the 7th position, they have introduced a chloro. Rest all moiety is same. Do you get? This is the first. Now let's go for the oxytetracycline. Oxy means introduction of your oxygen. So at the 5th position, there is an OH, which is of alpha configuration. So introduction of an extra OH in the tetracycline ring at the 5th position gives you oxytetracycline. That is oxytetracycline. Now let's go for the next. Dimethyltetracycline. Dimethyl means demethylated. Chlortetracycline. So chlortetracycline without a methyl at the 6th alpha position is known as demethylcycline. So what is demethylcycline? Demethylated at the 6th alpha position and a chlore at the seventh position. That is the example of demiclocycline. Okay, next is doxycycline. Now, what is this doxycycline? If you see, there is removal of OH from the sixth position and introduction of OH at the fifth position. So, what is the change? Your OH from your sixth position is removed, sixth A, and your OH at the
introduction of OH at the
fifth position. That is doxycycline. Okay, restol structure is almost the same. Now, next example is methacycline. So, what is the difference between methacycline and doxycycline? Only thing, introduction of a double bond. At the, see, your O, CH3 is replaced by CH2 double bond C. Okay, that's the difference between doxycycline and methacycline. They also contain an OH at the fifth position. So, methacycline and doxycycline, the only difference is the double bond. Metha means double bond. Now, minocycline. If you see minocycline, there is at the top OH, methyl, nothing is there. And we said that this is the most stable structure. And in your SIR, we studied that introduction of NN dimethyl group at the seventh position increases the activity as well as it increases the duration of action. So, this is the example of minocycline. Meclocycline, only thing is that introduction, it has got an OH and a methylenic group at the sixth position, OH at the fifth, and the chloro at the seventh. And tetracycline, it contains an amidic group, okay, at the ninth position. So, and an NN dimethyl amide. So, it has got, so if you say minocycline and tetracycline, they are same. Only thing that there is an amidic substitution at the ninth position. So, minocycline and tetracycline are the same compound. Only thing is that difference at the ninth position. So, these are the structures of your tetracyclines. Now, the chemical stability. Very important. Chemical stability. What do you mean by chemical instability? So, these compounds, as we said, similar to that of your penicillin. Even penicillins are not acid and base stable. There are some part in your structure that get modified in your environment of your body. Okay. So, what is the first thing? As I said, your NN dimethyl amino should be always of alpha configuration. So, in the acidic medium, so what happens? There will be a change in configuration at your C4 carbon. So, there will be a change in configuration at the C4 carbon. So, your alpha carbon gets converted into a beta. Your alpha amino, NN dimethyl amino, if it is changes to your beta, stereogenic center. So, that will epimerize and you get an inactive. This forms an epitetracycline, which is less active compared to your natural isomers. This is for the reasons, this is the only reason why the tetracycline has to be prepared freshly and to have maximum, other it changes its configuration. Next is acid instability. This thing is acid instability. In presence of acidic condition, so acidic means H+, they undergo dehydration at C5 and C6. They undergo dehydration. Your OH gets dehydrated. Okay? Your OH gets dehydrated. If you can see the structure, the OH at the sixth position. So, OH at the sixth position and your hydrogen at the sixth A position, they undergo dehydration and formation of a double bond. Okay? This is followed by a rearrangement. This is followed by a rearrangement. Your OH gets converted to your H. So, your OH, which is at the 11th position, it migrates to form your OH double bond, and the double bond between 11A and 12.
11A and 12 gets converted to your carbon.
So there is an entire shift of your bonds. There is an entire shift of your bonds. There is a formation of another aromatic ring. And as I said in your in the SAR, when the aromatic, only one ring can be aromatic. If the number of rings gets, more number of ring gets aromatized, the activity is lost. And this compound is known as 5,6 and hydro tetracycline. This is an inactive metabolite. So there is an aromatization that takes place. So first is dehydration, followed by spontaneous rearrangement, where the carbonyl group at the 11th position gets converted to an OH. There is a double bond between 11 and 11A. And the double bond between 11A and 12 gets converted into single bond, and the OH group gets converted to your carbonyl. So this is the modification that, that makes the compound inactive. Now let's go for the basic. What happens in the base? So you know base, they will act as a nucleophile. They attack, the base promotes a reaction between 6 and carbon 6 and 12. So what happens to form an inactive isotetracycline? So the base attacks on the carbonyl carbon of your level. Okay, the base attacks on the carbonyl carbon to form a lactone ring. So it forms an ester. If you see, it forms an ester. So it will attack on the carbon, it forms an acid. This acid will then remove your OH from the top. Okay, from the OH, from the you get a lactone ring. You get a lactone. The OH at the sixth position will be removed. So the best way to increase the base stability is to remove the OH from the sixth position. To remove the OH from the sixth, so that the lactonization does not take place. Okay, so all the dehydroxylated position, that is, they have got improved stability compared to the hydroxy compound. That's why your methicillin, your doxycycline and all are more stable compared to that of your tetracycline, because this lactone ring will not be formed. Okay, this lactone will not be formed and your isotetracycline will not be. So this is how you can increase the base instant. Now the formation of metal chelates. So what is this chelates? So you, if you have alkali metals with a low, unfilled orbitals, d orbitals there. So what will they form? They will form a coordinate complex with your groups which has got a lone pair of electrons, like your oxygen. So there is an conjugated OH and your carbonyl. So what these compounds will form? These metals will form a coordinate complex with your carbonyl and OH. And this is known as, these are stable chelate metal complexes formed by a tetracycline. Because this tetracycline contains your vacant, contains a lone pair of electrons in your carbonyl and your OH. So this will form a stable complex with metals like calcium, magnesium and iron. Such chelates are usually insoluble in water. So when they form the complex with the metals, the solubility of tetracycline reduces. So when the solubility reduces, it precipitates out. It precipitates out and they deposit on your teeth and all. So this, the affinity of tetracycline to calcium causes them to be incorporated only in into newly forming bones and teeth as tetracycline calcium orthophosphate complex. They will form a complex and the deposits of this antibiotics in teeth leads to yellow decolorization. So this leads to a deposition of your antibiotics on your teeth. Tetracyclines are distributed into the milk of the lactating mother and they can cross placental barrier of the fetus. So if possible, the possible effect of this agent is on the bones and teeth of the children should be considered before their use during pregnancy or in children under the age of 10. Because of this, they cannot be give, it cannot be given to lactating, it cannot be given to pregnant ladies as well as the kids below the age of 8. Otherwise, they get deposited in the, and moreover, they lead to formation of your stones also in the kidney because of the lesser salt. So, the mechanism of resistance. So, what is the mechanism of resistance? There are three mechanisms as we have studied earlier. Enzymatic, this is rarest of the type where the acetyl group is added to the molecule causing them inactive. So, your OH groups which are present in your diet get acylated by various acylating enzymes which are present in your micro. So, that will make the compound inactive. As we said, OH groups are at the 11th, 12th positions, 12A positions are necessary for your activity. If they get acylated, the binding will not take. Efflux mechanism. So, the gene efflux resistance gene code on the membrane proteins that actively pumps your tetracyclines out of the cell. So, there will be an efflux mechanism within your micron that will efflux, remove your tetracycline and prevent it from binding at the sites, ribosome. Ribosomal protection which blocks the binding of your tetracycline to your, so there will be some modification in the ribosomes of your micron. There will be modification so that the tetracycline do not bind to the ribosomes. So these are the possible three mechanisms of your microbial resistance. Clinical uses, treatment of infection caused by Bacillus pneumonia, Clamidium, Rickettsia, Vibrios and Spirochetes. Secondary alternate use in treatment of syphilis, treatment of respiratory infection caused by susceptible organism because it's a broad spectrum antibiotic. Treatment of leptospirosis, treatment of acne, yeah, it is used in the treatment of acne. Prophylaxis against injections in chronic bronchitis. So these are the uses of tetracycline, yeah. Side effects, stomach upset, diarrhea, itching of the rectum or vagina, sore mouth, redness in your skin, change in decolorization of the skin. Yeah, this is one of the major adverse effect of tetracycline. Nails decolorization, difficulty in breathing or swallowing, extreme weakness and permanent decolorization of your teeth. So, these are the side effects of tetracycline.